Welcome students to the video module on dual nature of matter. In the previous modules we learned that radiation possesses dual character, that is it behave in some situations radiation behave as waves, while in some other situations radiation behaved as particles. So from many such observations, scientists concluded that radiation possesses dual character. Which are the situations we learned regarding this? While explaining phenomena such as photoelectric effect, Einstein showed that light is composed of particles called photons. But at the same time, wave nature of light is used to explain phenomena like interference, diffraction, etc. This shows that radiation has two completely different behavior, particle as well as waves, or it has got a dual character, a dual nature for radiation. This prompted many scientists to think in a different way. And a scientist, Louis Victor de Broglie, even though his name is spelling is this B-R-O-G-L-I-E, it is pronounced as de Broglie. Okay, Louis Victor de Broglie. He is a French physicist. He proposed an entirely new idea, because the entire nature is made up of two entities. One is radiation and the other one is matter. Everything is made up of these two, energy, radiation and matter. And scientists successfully proved that radiation possesses dual nature. Then de Broglie argued that since nature prefers symmetry and matter and radiation are the two entities of universe, matter should also possess dual behavior as possessed by radiation. So his argument is that as one entity of this universe, radiation possesses dual nature, the other entity also must possess the same type of behavior, that is particle nature as well as wave nature. And he introduced a term called matter waves in order to specify the waves associated with material particles. So Louis Victor de Broglie proposed an idea that each material particle is associated with a wave, and he called these waves as matter waves. So what are matter waves? Matter waves are nothing but the waves associated with material particles. We know that matter has got a particle nature. Everything is made up of particles. Every matter is made up of particles. But he argued that these particles has got wave nature also, and named as matter waves. So matter waves are the waves associated with material particles. And you know, he was awarded a Nobel Prize in Physics in the year 1929 for introducing these ideas regarding matter waves. Okay, see his idea of matter waves. He proposed the idea of matter waves, and matter waves possess a wavelength lambda equal to h divided by p, where p stands for momentum, because material particles, its mass m and is moving the velocity v. So lambda is equal to h divided by p, That is why it is lambda is equal to h divided by mv. It's a wavelength. Where lambda is the de Broglie wavelength, the wavelength of matter waves, the de Broglie wavelength. And h is the Planck's constant, whose value is 6.626 10 to the power negative 34 kilogram meter square per second. Mass is mass of electron. If it is electron, okay, this is not necessarily be electron, but he proposed that for electron only, okay. So m is the mass of the particle. If it is electron, it is 9.1 10 to the power minus 31. This is an example only. Okay, so from here onwards, it is an example. So you consider, you know, okay, it is difficult to identify the matter waves associated with macro particles or large particles. Why? Let us see. Lambda is equal to h divided by mv. If you are considering a large particle of mass 1 gram or 1 kilogram or 2 kilogram like that, then the denominator, you know, h, the value of h itself is 10 to the power negative 34. So when you divide it with a mass 1 kilogram particle, if you substitute mass 1 kilogram and a velocity some other value, then the wavelength will be very less. It's of the order of 10 to the power minus 30s. So the wavelength is very, very less. So the particle's wavelength, see. So a larger particle with this type of a wavelength. So it is not possible for us to distinguish the wave behavior. So for us, that particle appear to move in a straight path only. There will not be any such type of a movement there. But when you consider the case of particles like electrons, microparticles like electron, see, the mass of electron is 9.1 times 10 to the power minus 31. So 10 to the power minus 31 at the denominator, then that value, the value of wavelength will be a significant one, and we can distinguish the wave nature associated with the particles such as electron. So later it is proved also, this matter wave concept given by de Broglie, Louis Victor de Broglie. Actually, you know, de Broglie coined the two entities. Here he proposed the expression for wavelength associated with a material particle as lambda is equal to wavelength lambda is equal to Planck's constant h divided by momentum p. So lambda is equal to h divided by p. That is for material particles. Now consider for light or energy of a photon. So if you consider the photon, the case of photon, then we know that energy of a photon E is equal to h nu. Okay, and the relativistic energy of a photon is given by E is equal to pc. This is the expression for the relativistic energy of a particle. But as a photon has got zero mass, this term becomes zero. So root of p square c square, that gives to pc. P is the momentum and c is the speed of light. So that is why this expression there, E is equal to pc, E is equal to h nu. Okay. Now, combining these two terms, h nu is equal to pc. This is, what is nu? The frequency nu. Nu is equal to c divided by lambda. So, hc divided by lambda equal to pc. Cancel. This gives lambda is equal to h divided by p. Lambda is equal to h by p. H is the Planck's constant. P is the momentum of photon. So that is the expression for wavelength. A simple expression for wavelength he derived for matter wave also give the same. Lambda is equal to, that is for material particle. Lambda is equal to Planck's constant divided by momentum. Okay. So what are matter waves? Matter waves are the waves associated with material particles. and they possess a wavelength lambda is equal to h divided by p, and similar expression for wavelength for photon also. Okay, now now consider an electron of charge E moving or accelerated by a potential V volt. V is not velocity, it is potential. Okay, so an electron accelerated by a potential V volt. So how much is the potential energy imparted to this? It is E times V. It's a potential energy. Due to this potential energy, or the electron starts moving, then it converts to kinetic energy. So its expression for kinetic energy, it is half times mass of electron times velocity square. This V is velocity and the capital V is potential. Okay, so we also know that momentum of electron is given by mv. Okay, so you can do a simple mathematical step here. Half, just multiply with m, divide with m here, so it will become m square v square. So then it will be half m, what is mv is momentum, right? So here p square. So we can write kinetic energy k equal to p square divided by 2m. So p equal to 2m k. So p square equal to 2mk. P equal to square root of 2mk. But k is the kinetic energy. But we know that this kinetic energy is imparted by the potential energy due to the applied potential. So we can replace k with 2m. K can be replaced by the potential energy. This is K, and that's EV is the potential energy expression. So it is 2m EV, capital B. This expression for the momentum. This is for electron. Okay, if in general you can write P is equal to root of 2m QV for any particle. This capital V is potential, and P is momentum. This is momentum. Okay. So once again, consider a charged particle accelerated by a potential V. Then the expression for potential energy is charge times potential. If it is electron, it is E times V. And the expression for kinetic energy is half mv square. So due to the applied potential, the particle accelerates, moves. So kinetic energy is half mv square. Multiply on the top and bottom with m, you will get m square v square by 2m. This m square v square is replaced by p, the momentum, so p square by 2m. Cross multiplying, you will get a p square equal to 2mk, or p equal to 2mk. Now the k, the kinetic energy, is replaced by the expression for potential energy, that is ev or qv for any charge. So the momentum p is equal to root of 2mqv. If it is electron, then it is root of 2mev. So we got expression for potential there. Now the de Broglie wavelength lambda can be written as h divided by p, that is equal to h divided by root of 2mqv for any particle, and for electron in particular it is h divided by root of 2mev, where v is the potential applied. So we can see that here h is constant. In the case of electron, you can consider mass is constant, e the charge is constant, and h is also constant. So the expression for wavelength is given by around, it is equal to square root of 150 divided by potential, that much angstrom. One angstrom is 10 to the power minus 10 meter. So the expression for lambda wavelength for electron accelerated by a potential V is root of 150 divided by V. H and M and E are constants. That is why he arrived at this expression. So all these derived from de Broglie's equation for lambda is equal to h by p and simple mathematical rearrangements. So the expression for wavelength of an electron accelerated by a potential v is given by square root of 150 divided by v angstrom.